Welcome to Inside Gaming. I'm Brian with the Weekend Roundup. We got some good Anthem news and some bad Anthem news for you guys. All right, it's mostly bad. But let's get to the good part first. After weeks of no communication, the games team at BioWare put out a new update for the game. That's good, right? Sure, everybody likes updates. But the bad news is it didn't really address one of the biggest issues with the game, content. Now, according to the notes, it did add some legendary missions and some quality of life stuff like fast travel, but in a note to players, community manager Jesse Anderson said that most of the improvements are under the hood. That's good, the game definitely needs that, but what about the Cataclysm? That was the big in-game event that was supposed to be out in May, and by the time you're watching this video, it's definitely not May anymore. Probably not. Well, Anderson said they're still working on Cataclysm. They're releasing a public test server on PC that'll let players see the content while it's being developed and give us the chance to offer feedback. He added, rather than rush it out the door, we want to take time and get feedback from you and make changes based on what we hear. Oh, now they don't want to rush it out the door. Y'all should have taken that advice 3 months ago. Anyway, we did get a first look at the Cataclysm event on Thursday during a live stream. It's going to be an 8-week event where you're loaded into special areas and you gotta clear as many as you can before time runs out. You can also earn back time by doing various activities, and there's a final boss at the end to beat. It kind of reminds me of the Verdant Forest from Destiny 2, which I had to do a million times to get the Arbalest, and then I remembered how much I hate linear fusion rifles. Anyway, Cataclysm.
Nerd!
I'm just saying, that gun, ugh. Cataclysm is also going to be score-driven, which seems to mean that the more points you get, the better the rewards.
Talk about loot fools.
Okay.
Maybe we could rephrase the question to be slightly more respectful.
Now, the game's lead producer, Ben Irving, also said that the gear you'll get from Cataclysm will be 5 levels higher, a whopping 5, than the current in-game gear.
Fools.
So that's something that players have definitely been wanting, but it still seems like it's very much in the beta stages at this point. And as you might imagine, there's no release date yet. So it's definitely good they're still working on the game, but all the tweaks they're having to make are clearly throwing them off their content roadmap. And BioWare has warned that this would happen, and it's not gonna be a short journey. Back in April, they wrote on Reddit, "We fixed a lot of bugs and made changes which we believe begin to point us in the right direction for the future. That being said, we know there's a long way to go before Anthem becomes the game we all want it to be." Now, the other problem is that Anthem's player base, as we reported, is almost gone now. On the Xbox One, Microsoft keeps a running list of the top 49 most played games. Anthem still is not on it, and its stats on Twitch are basically nothing. So props to BioWare for continuing to work on the game, but at this point, it seems like Anthem is on life support, and it might need more help than BioWare and EA can give it. At this point, maybe the best bet is just completely take the game down like Square Enix did with Final Fantasy XIV. Take the time to make it an acceptable product, because people paid $60 for this and it's still not worth it, to be honest. All right, moving on. We got another major studio executive accused of sexual harassment. Kotaku reported that Geronimo Barrera, a former Rockstar Games vice president who worked there for 2 decades, allegedly groped a fellow employee. Barrera had a reputation at the company for being a dick, to say the least, and former Rockstar designer Colin Bunchu says that at a company event in 2014, Barrera aggressively groped him. Bunchu complained to HR, who said they did an investigation, but that the allegations could not be substantiated. Now, for his part, Barrera also denied wrongdoing. He left Rockstar last year after working on Red Dead Redemption 2. Looks like we're gonna see that Avengers project that Square Enix has been working on very soon. The game's Twitter account says that we'll get a worldwide reveal of Marvel's Avengers during Square Enix's E3 event on June 10th. Now, we've known for a while that Square Enix was working on an Avengers project, haven't heard much since, but Twitter user Evan Filarka found a listing for the game at the E3 Coliseum event, and it had a description about the game saying that it will have, quote, continuous single player and cooperative gameplay. It also says you can assemble and
get it. You can assemble. You get
Spoiler. It also says you can assemble in teams up to 4 players, master extraordinary abilities, customize your hero to fit your playstyle, and combine powers to defend an ever-expanding world under constant threat. Sounds a little Destiny-ish, a little bit. At any rate, we will know more soon. At any rate, I meant to say. At any rate, my wife. That was a good Borat, guys. That was free. We might be getting some story DLC for Borderlands 2 to help us get all ready for Borderlands 3 in a few months. PlayStation Lifestyle reports that Gearbox is working on a DLC expansion to bridge the gap between the end of Borderlands 2 and the beginning of Borderlands 3. It's reportedly called Commander Lilith and the Fight for Sanctuary, and word is it might release during E3. Lilith, of course, was a vault hunter in the first game and has popped up in the series ever since, so we'll see. That could be cool. Microsoft is putting a lot more of its PC games on Steam and announced that 20 PC games, including Gears of War 4, and all the Age of Empires Definitive Editions will be added to the store. This follows an announcement they made in March that the Halo Master Chief Collection would be coming to Steam as well, so think of them as the anti-Epic Game Store. In an announcement, Microsoft said, "We know millions of PC gamers trust Steam as a great source to buy PC games, and we've heard the feedback that PC gamers would like choice." Microsoft has also said it's bringing Xbox Game Pass to PC, and we will, of course, learn more at E3. This is that time of the year where we'll just learn more about everything at E3. All right, the band Iron Maiden has filed a $2 million lawsuit against the maker of Duke Nukem, the heavy metal band that you're probably too young to remember, but I'm not, accused 3D Realms of, quote, incredibly blatant trademark infringement because of a game called Iron Maiden. Iron Maiden, who could probably use $2 million these days, said that the infringement could lead to confusion among consumers, despite the fact that Iron Maiden is a video game and Iron Maiden is a bunch of dudes who qualify for AARP. But you know what? Good for them for knowing what video games are. I would not have guessed that.
You know, here's the crazy thing about Iron Maiden. Like, they play some decent-sized shows here in the States.
Yeah.
Dude, they play in
Europe.
Are
they huge? Are they huge over...
Europe and South America? Huh. Like, I've seen some videos. It's insane.
Yeah, like, remember when Guns N' Roses was, like, broken up here, but they would, like, pop up in Rio,
yeah,
and there would be, like, 2 billion people?
Dude,
yeah.
The shows in Rio, I've seen some videos of shows in Rio, like, like metal shows. That, massive.
They're crazy. South Americans are crazy about metal.
Yeah, they are.
Sound off if you're a South American. Let us know. Just two old dudes talking about metal right here. All right, now it's time for the 5-second review. Let's go.
Brian, we're rolling, my dude.
Oh, shit. All right, sweet. Let's talk about new games coming out next week. Up first, it's another Warhammer game. Recently, it feels like we've had either a Warhammer or a Warhammer 40K game come out every week. This one is called Warhammer Chaosbane. It's a Diablo-esque hack and slasher with four character classes. It can be played single player or with up to four players in either online or local co-op. Couch co-op, always a good thing. You can pick this one up June 4th for PC, PS4, and Xbox One. Apparently, the Switch hasn't completely killed development for the 3DS. It mostly has. But Persona Q2 New Cinema Labyrinth, which was released last year in Japan, it's releasing everywhere else this week. It features the cast from Persona 5 who find themselves trapped in a weird movie world. There, Joker and the Phantom Thieves will battle against new foes and run into folks from Persona 3 and 4. New Persona stuff, always good. Now give us Persona 5 on the Switch, come on! Persona Q2 New Cinema Labyrinth is releasing for the 3DS June 4th. A remake of a 1989 arcade classic, Toki, the game, is a platformer where you play as Toki, a warrior who has been turned into an ape by an evil sorcerer and a demon. Sounds like a fable, kinda. The demon and sorcerer kidnap Toki's love, Miho, and now Toki, the warrior turned ape, must walk, jump, swim, climb, and spit his way through a ton of enemies to save her. Toki, the game, has been out on Switch for a little over 5 months now, but you can pick it up on PC, Mac, PS4, and Xbox One on June 6th.
Hey, you can play it on Mac!
It's Toki the game?
No, it's Toki, but because it has Toki,
you wanted to differentiate.
And then the warrior.
Got it.
And then the Toki the game. Like, yeah, it was just a lot of Tokis, man.
All right. A beloved PlayStation exclusive is finally coming to PC. Journey. Oh, that's a good game. The beautiful exploration adventure game was released for PS3 in 2012. And again on PS4, 3 years later. It's won a ton of awards over the years. If you haven't had a chance to play it, definitely worth checking out. Comes to Epic Game Store June 6th. All right, this is different. It's a game porting from the Switch to the PC. It's Octopath Traveler. This JRPG has you playing as 8 different characters, each with their own stories and side quests. You will battle enemies in turn-based combat while solving problems and making decisions that will shape your path. It's good. It's worth checking out. It's on PC June 7th. And lastly, porting its way over to the Xbox One, it's Omen Sight Definitive Edition. Omen Sight is an action game with a murder mystery. Here's a description on Steam. You are the Harbinger, a mythical warrior who only appears in times of crisis. The land of Euralia is torn by war, and as night falls, you witness its destruction at the hands of a dark god. As the eyes and the sword of Euralia is up to you to reverse this fate. All you know is that it started with a mysterious murder. The game has a great style. What do you mean, great style?
They're seeing it right now, my dude.
Oh, that's true. All right. Yeah. Well, as you can see for yourself, the game has a great style, and it'll feature Xbox One X support, meaning 4K goodness. It's already out on PC, PS4, and the Switch, but it's coming to the Xbox One June 7th. All right. That is all the news we've got for you today. Hope you have a great weekend. We'll see you right here very soon on Inside Gaming.
You know, before we take off, that is a sweet Inside Gaming shirt that you have there, Brian.
I think they're for sale right now.
They are for sale right now in the RT store. We limited supply. We're going to have a bunch more at RTX.
Okay.
But after that, if they sell out, we'll get some more. So,
do we get a cut? Do we get any points on these?
Us personally?
Yeah.
Hell no, we don't get a cut. But the channel.
Well, then I don't care if you buy it or not. Do what you want.
I think Lawrence gets a cut, though.
And of course.
Happy, if Lawrence is happy, then
that's
true.
Then
it makes
happy.
Our lives easier.
Yeah, you know what? I got this for free.
Yeah, you did.
We got some bad Anthem news for you guys this Thursday. Imagine that! We did it! Yeah! More Anthem stuff! Woo!
Well, it's not doing so well. And obviously that's not news to any of you, but it looks like Anthem's playbase has now completely collapsed.
Yes. The strong castle on the hill that was the Anthem player base has now fallen into the swamp.